Oh my, that is really cool.
As a lover of flexible, affordable tech, I have a special place in my heart for Raspberry Pi. These ultra-cheap single-board computers have historically been a big hit among hobbyists, with plenty of versions making their ways on retro gaming builds and even industrial products. Since I found myself a bit in between other videos, I wanted to revisit some of my Raspberry Pi gaming fascinations, which a fair number of you clearly enjoyed as well. There is, however, one problem. I am not at home. I will not be at home in months and did not bring any Raspberry Pis with me. I could potentially just buy one online, but then I remembered that the Raspberry Pi Trading Company was opening an official store. Just one store on their home turf in Cambridge. Cambridge is not very far from my current location, so...
How about we go on a little road trip?
Raspberry Pi. It started from an observation. The PC is the most powerful, flexible platform there is, but as people engage more with higher level closed systems, like game consoles or most smartphones, the number of people interested in working with lower level programming might be impacted. Heck, our current PCs are a far cry from the low-level programmable personal devices of old, especially when it comes to hardware access. If you're a PC enthusiast, you might be comfortable digging into the guts of your machine, but when was the last time you opened a laptop or a console? This led a group of engineers and creators wondering if they could design a small, affordable, and programmable computer geared towards education. And the rest? The rest is history. While success always breeds competition, one of the biggest assets for Raspberry Pi is its large community. If you're learning and you have an issue, even if a bit obscure, chances are someone online has gone through it or already experienced it, or at least knows what causes it. And there are hundreds of accessories, sensors, and kits to build some rather specific devices. This explosion of variety is beautifully reflected in one physical place here, the one and currently only Raspberry Pi official store. But why would a non-profit like Raspberry Pi build a store?
Well, Raspberry Pi is an interesting company because we're a licensing organization, right? We design Raspberry Pi. We license that design to partners who then have Raspberry Pis made, sell them typically to distributors who then sell them to customers.
This is Eben Upton. He's one of the original founders of the Raspberry Pi Foundation, the current CEO of Raspberry Pi Trading, and a very important contributor to the story of this device.
So we're a long way away from our customers usually. It can be very hard for us to find out what our customers want from Raspberry Pi, and even more importantly, it can be extremely hard to find out why people who haven't bought Raspberry Pis haven't bought Raspberry Pis. You know, companies worry about their customers a lot. They really often should worry about their non-customers. So really what the store's about is about getting us closer, even in a little pocket environment, in one town, in one country, giving us the ability to get a little bit closer to our customers, and in particular, getting closer to customers maybe who are require a little bit of reassurance before they decide to commit to Raspberry Pi as a platform.
The mission to use the store as a place of exploration and to discover what questions people might have about Raspberry Pi is evident when you consider that more than half of the store is occupied by a variety of demo stations, either displaying some of the educational features of the Pi, such as programming with Scratch or playing around with inputs and outputs, and also displays many cool-looking projects and toys, such as this dump game that I would absolutely have loved as a kid, and this kits to build mini arcades that were just... calling me. So tempting. Now this story is pretty new, and I originally thought it was just a limited test run rather than a hint at the future expansion. So I had to ask Eden why there's only one store in the world, and turns out, it might not be the last.
Well, there's only one because at one point there was zero, and maybe in the future there'll be more, and there has to be a time between there being zero stores and being many stores when there's one store. And that's the time. That's the time when you visited our store. Look, the store, if this store never makes money, then it will still have been worthwhile for the reasons I mentioned. if the store here in Cambridge makes money, because Cambridge is kind of a special place, but it can never make money somewhere else in a less unusual town, then it will obviously still have been worth it. I think that we have a number, between here and there being 1,000 stores, there are a number of gates, and we may not get through all of those gates. We may not even get through the first gate. Yeah, you're just visiting here at a very special time.
But if the possibility arises in the future, that will be something that, like, might, if those gates are overcome, that might be a thing that happens.
Yes. Yeah. We've been running it, let's see, so March, April, May. So we've been running about 3 months. And we're very happy with how the store's going in terms of helping us get closer to our customers. You know, we are getting really high quality feedback about what people actually want to buy. You know, about what the things are, what the collateral is that goes with a Raspberry Pi that can be put in there with a Raspberry Pi to make it valuable. So we have a number of people who have bought their first Raspberry Pi, often for their children, and they've come back a couple of weeks later and said, this is great, we're having fun, but what we really need are more ideas for projects. It's easy for us to imagine. It's obvious what to do with a Raspberry Pi. Yeah. But for a lot of people, it isn't.
You mentioned that Cambridge is a magical place in that sense. So why Cambridge?
Several reasons. One, it's our hometown, so it's extremely convenient. Two, it has a technically literate demographic, which kind of guarantees a shop like that a certain base of customers. You know, there's a lot of people like me who want to go out, get up in the morning, go buy oscilloscopes. And having a shop where you can do that is very useful. So you kind of guaranteed some sort of base of custom. And what you also have, importantly, is you have a lot of people who are intelligent and inquisitive and want the best for their children. So you have both a town where you have your kind of core customer base that can potentially make the place profitable on its own, but you also have exactly the kind of people we're trying to reach. You know, non-technical people who are inquisitive about new experiences.
The other half of the story is dedicated to not only the growing number of available Raspberry Pis, but the many, many accessories and kits. The staple kit is this beautiful red box. Aimed at beginners, these kits include all the accessories needed to get started with Raspberry Pi projects. They also have a shelf for books and magazines for projects and learning at any level, in case you prefer a physical object to guide you through your creative journey. This is all next to the very important and cool merch corner, because it's 2019, and if it does not have merch, it does not exist. Yeah, I know, I'm working on it. Another topic where my assumptions were wrong was gaming. Given the focus on education, I initially thought they might not be too keen on the gaming focus that a lot of people have put in the Pi. Turns out, I was also wrong on this.
So, I imagine reading up on the Foundation's history that always the target was education. However, there's many, many people who buy Raspberry Pis as gaming machines.
Yes, right.
Was this something that surprised you, that caught you off guard?
No, I think I've actually been surprised in the other direction. I've been surprised that there isn't more gaming on Raspberry Pi. Obviously, there's a big retro gaming community. One of the earliest demos we showed, obviously, was Quake 3. Back in the summer of 2011, we showed Quake 3 running on a Raspberry Pi. It was the first thing that really demonstrated to people that we had a serious amount of multimedia power on the system. There's obviously a lot of retro gaming, and that's not surprising. The machines that we are inspired by from the 1980s, they were games machines. You know, the BBC Micro, the Commodore 64, the Sinclair Spectrum, they all had gaming functionality. People played games on them. We've always had this idea that we want Raspberry Pi to be fun. It's not like taking your medicine. You know, it's a fun device. It plays video, it plays games. You take it into your life, maybe in order to play games on it, but it comes shipped with all the tools that you need. Unlike a legacy PC, it ships with all of the tools that you need from day one to become a games programmer yourself.
The store clearly embraces this idea. Sometimes in the most direct sense, where they make workshops where they use simplified versions of Minecraft to teach coding, a side activity that has become a staple of the Pi education system. But the influence of the gaming phenomenon that the gaming and maker community has transformed Raspberry Pi into is obvious in many other places, such as the types of USB gamepads that you could see in random corners of the store, or the books about coding games, the magazines about PC building. And that takes me back to this kid of building a Raspberry Pi arcade that I just could not get off my mind. And you guys definitely were not helping. So, I am convinced I totally need this to do a video on it, and not at all because I want to put one together personally. purchases of the store currently can come with a copy of the official Raspberry Pi magazine or a current edition of the project book and a tote bag depending on how much you spend. So I found myself leaving with a fair bit more stuff than I expected. Which I don't mind because some of the stuff in these books is just plain fun or informational to read and it is very nice quality paper. Such a nice sound. If you want to follow along as I assemble and review the stuff I bought, then you know how the system works. I'm working on those videos right now. My conversation with Eben Upton was much longer than I expected or represented on this video, so you will have to keep an eye on those future videos to hear his full thoughts on Raspberry Pi gaming, the magic powers that make the affordability of the Raspberry Pi possible, and some other surprises. Thank you to Raspberry Pi Trading for letting me film on the store and Mr. Upton for answering my questions. And you for watching.